there's something else. So
no worries.
All right.
So Holland, do you want to go ahead and start the meeting?
Yep. Call the meeting to order. I need to find the agenda unless somebody wants to coach me along because I didn't have it in front of me.
Go ahead and start with approval of minutes.
I'd like to do approval of the minutes. If there's anybody who has any questions or additions or changes or would like to go ahead and approve, make a motion.
I'll make a motion to approve.
Thank you. We have a second.
I'll second.
Thank you. All right.
And you say all those in favor?
All those in favor?
Aye.
Great. All right.
Any opposed?
No, they're not. Nope. Any opposed? Okay.
Okay, so the next one was supposed to be visitor comments if we had someone from the Business Development Commission. I don't see him on, but they were basically just going to continue to be here and be involved and let you know that they're trying to work on things as they coordinate with all the different business districts and businesses, and they're continuing to look at things related to upgrades to the website and the new social media. So I think that was pretty much all he was going to say.
Excellent.
Can I insert there that I've already dropped off of the Web Business Development Commission? It was a short stint. I missed it twice. I know that I'm going to miss it in June. I'm going to miss it in July. Just the challenges of a whole lot of things are firing the restaurant back up is like building a whole new restaurant. It's been very time consuming. Amongst my son graduating and a whole bunch of other excuses that I have why I couldn't be 100%. And I would love to revisit it someday and join in the fall, but we have lost our Old Orchard representation to the Business Development Commission because I missed two in a row and was going to miss four in a row. And it just seemed, I didn't want to be a slacker. So sorry, everybody. If anyone else wants to step up, they can.
Holland, next item, old business, facade program. So last month I shared, and I'm going to go ahead and just share from the minutes because I know Fran added them to the minutes and I've got the PDF right here. We had talked about a draft of the potential for the facade program. And we were going to have everybody kind of look at it, see what they thought, and make some decisions on whether you wanted to edit it, make changes, or move it forward and get started with allowing people to apply for the facade program.
Did anyone, after careful review since last time we met, have any suggestion or changes or... I definitely, I'm a fan of let's move it ahead, but I don't know if anybody has any small changes because if we pass it and we decide a year from now that we want to make some modifications, we can, right?
Totally. At any time we can revisit. This is so, it's not that it's informal, but it's something that you all decide as a commission. And it's just helping you to determine when you do want to, you have the money in the budget, but when you want to spend that money, we just need a reason, you know, we need to be able to show why we gave that money to whomever applies.
And what we were basing ours on is the one that Crossroads currently uses.
Correct.
And yeah. So we're just sort of adopting someone else's.
I just adopted essentially what they had done, which was trying to think, you know, to think about things that could be funded, things that would continue to stay with the property versus things that one are just general repairs that they should be maintaining on their own building. Any deferred maintenance couldn't get covered and things that would leave with the business. So like a business sign, it can't be used for signage, but everything else was, you know, able to be used. And then there is a maximum amount, which was listed, I think, up here. Maximum of 2,000 per grant has to be matched by the applicant. Total amount available within each fiscal year is limited. based on how much you put in your budget each year. And then we do have it as one application per business or building and one grant per property. It's not limited based on ownership. So in Crossroads, they had a couple businesses that buildings that were owned by the same owner. So they wanted to make sure that they could still, you know, do it to each of the separate physical buildings. But so it was supposed to be that you just couldn't get multiple grants for the same property.
And this is just going to be ongoing?
This can be ongoing based on how you do your budget. So like Crossroads only puts in one grant every year. They're small enough. They most often end up finding something for one grant per year, but because they've actually been giving it out almost every year, pretty much most of their buildings have received it at this point. There's, you know, there's a couple out there that still haven't, but they've been, you know, moving along pretty quickly through it each year. You initially in for last year's budget had put in for potentially three.
Yeah, I remembered three. I'd like to still do three.
Yep, and you had put in your budget for three. Now here's the thing, because the end of your budget year ends at the end of this month, you could make the determination that you still want to spend, you know, for anything that might have been done in this past year with any of the businesses that have done anything in this past year that might want to apply. I can put the money in a purchase order and hold it over from last year's budget. I know we did go ahead and put another three into this coming year's budget, which starts July 1. So you could continue, you can make that determination. And if you want me to put it in a purchase order, I can.
How would you determine that what they did?
They would have to do the same grant. We would just be reviewing it post. We would just be, you know, we would be reviewing it and rewarding it after the fact for those three.
Correct.
So I did some changes in landscape and you're like, there was $2,000 of flowers. I mean, I'm being facetious, but you know what I mean?
They have to provide us with the receipts. So we do use the receipts. So there has to be receipts that are within that budget year.
Okay.
And then if it was something that was on the structure that required a building permit, copy the building permit. So yeah.
And then is there a time frame as to when they apply? I mean, is this like, you know what I'm asking? Okay, by every March 12th, I'm sorry.
Right. So the way that the Crossroads did it, they were pretty flexible because again, they only had one a year and they usually only had one project that even was remotely eligible each year. So they kind of left it of, it's a first come first serve. You can apply at any time during the year. Most people apply when they are applying for architecture review board. So when they are going and getting the design looked at, they are going ahead and applying to you at the same time. And so usually what they do is they take whatever they're got approved by architecture review board. That might be, you know, opening up the facade, opening up windows in the upper portion because it's been covered with boards, whatever that is, they then provide that as part of their application because it's already been approved by ARB. And then using that, then sometimes the project might take a little while. And so I usually try to get an update and try to figure out if I can still pay it out of that same budget year. And if by some chance, like let's just say they applied in April and then they haven't finished the project by June 30th, I would then have a purchase order and I'd hold that money over to make sure that we had it to pay when the project does get completed.
I think we should do it.
Hold money over for this past year. Mm-hmm. I'd probably want you guys to vote on that just so that I'm comfortable on that.
I mean, do we need to do two separate votes? One for like holding over and then one, well, do we need to do a general one to say we're gonna do this program and then do a second one that says we're gonna do this?
So you already did the general one that you were doing the program last year. But okay. We never put the rules and regulations in place for how we would approve them. So this would be doing a vote on, are you comfortable with the application as well as the, you know, the rules for how the eligibility. So application and eligibility would be one vote, and then holding over the 6,000 from the 2021 budget year in a purchase order would be the second vote.
Okay. Unless we have other questions or clarifications, I will make a motion to approve the application and all you those other great.
Make a motion as the chairperson.
Oh, someone else has to make the motion.
Someone else great. Has to make the motion.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second.
Okay, I can't all see everybody. So who was that?
Steve and then Ken.
No, that was Ken.
All Steve in made the favor. Motion.
Aye.
Any opposed? All right, and then we need someone to make a second motion for Mara to do the PO to hold over.
Hold on just a second. I'm sorry, I didn't see that Bob had come on as an attendee and I had to move him over because I had the screen share up.
Thank God.
I'm bringing him over twice because I wasn't sure which is which.
Stressful.
He needed to like put his hand up. I'm here.
I could not find the link this morning and I've been texting people. So here I am.
Sorry.
For any- there were so many repeat emails that I could not find the link on any of them. No, so I went to.
If anyone ever can't find the link, if you go to the city website, we put the links for all meetings on there.
Yeah, that's how I got on there.
But okay, good. We were on a screen share, so I couldn't see you over to the side.
Yeah, I was watching all that, so I approve.
And Holland was taking over your duties.
Yes, I saw you doing a great job. Way to go.
So we did the first vote. Sorry, we were going to do a second one. I don't know if Holland or Bob, whichever one of you wants to take over, we were going to need a second vote. Regarding moving over the $6,000 from the 2021 budget year.
Bob can take over, so I'll make the motion that we roll over for the $6,000 for the 2021 year.
I'll second, Angel.
Perfect. And then do all those in favor?
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, awesome. Bob, do you have the agenda in front of you or do you need me to tell you what's next? Yeah,
I do have the printed agenda, but where did we just finish?
We just
budget update?
Old business facade program.
Okay. Old business facade. Okay, I see facade program. Are there BDC update?
We're further down. So the next thing actually would be streetscape update. And I apologize, I do not have, sorry, Bob, you okay?
Yeah, I'm good, I got it.
So I don't have the latest streetscape update. I was gonna try to get it this morning and I didn't get to the Public Works Director before our meeting started at 8. I know they were still waiting for those that, I see this every day, but many of you might not, but construction materials, are in so much in demand that it's taking forever to get certain things. So I believe they're still being held up due to the street poles needing to arrive. You don't want to start with the sidewalk until we get the street poles. And I believe that there was a delay on those. So I will send out an email as soon as I know what the timing is going to be on the construction starting. But they were postponing it because they didn't want to leave you all with like a partial where they would do the sidewalk and then be, you know, just have the little pole base and the wires waiting for it. So I will get an update to you as soon as I can and I'll email it out to everyone.
Okay. Gazebo series.
Do you guys have an update?
It looks like we've got them all lined up, ready to go. I don't have any other further updates. I didn't talk to Stacy about the movies yet.
think, was it Fran who put the email out? I did read that email. It sounds like a lot of the did, and we're a go with trying to like start to solicit sponsorship support.
Correct.
So is that the, I think that's the phase that we're at with it is.
We're trying to schedule a meeting for next week to answer some miscellaneous questions. Sounded like so far from the folks I've heard that next week sometime everybody was available. Anybody in the commission that wants to join the organizers can do that. We're actually talking about having a meeting in person next week.
Wow.
I don't know. Do we know how to do that anymore?
Where's the link?
Yeah, but now that the county has dropped everything, everything is now in high gear.
Yeah. Fran, do you want to back out?
I'm sorry, what?
Could you put that meeting email back out one more time for next week and see, did anybody respond to what day or anything? I did.
No, they just said next week was better.
Yeah, I thought so too. I know Wednesday's not good, but maybe, I don't know. John, do you have any ideas? Maybe Thursday or Tuesday? Tuesday.
Wednesday, Thursday, Friday were not good for me. So I shot that back. I know Fran ends up trying to work this puzzle of who can do it and who can't. So I got Monday, Tuesday available.
How about you, Bob?
Well, Tuesday. Yes, I'm available Tuesday.
Okay, we'll shoot for that. Try to get everybody.
I'll see
else.
If I can talk to. I'll talk to Stacy before.
Yeah, that was the one thing I don't have any information on that.
Dale said he was out of town this week. Do you know if he's in town next week?
I don't, but I will find out. I will find out.
He'd be good to have there.
Okay.
I don't want to just give an update after that. So, and I'll talk to Stacy before Tuesday and see if she can join. Okay. Budget update next.
We had, I think you're looking at another agenda. Trash can review.
I'm looking at the wrong. What's that?
That's okay.
I thought I printed the last one off you sent, but why don't we just have.
So the next thing was discussing the trash cans. So I'm going to share my screen for a second. So you guys put in your budget.
I must have the wrong one.
That's okay. We'd kind of talked through, we did the budget update last month. And then this month we'd taken that back off. And we had the trash can review. So for those that remember, we had put in the budget to order 2 to 3 trash cans based on costs that came in. The cost came in pretty close to what we had estimated. But what I wanted to show you is that we have this is a city map where they mark off where we're supposed to have trash cans so that when they send out the mapping to the company that picks them up, that they know exactly where they are and make sure that they get all the trash cans picked up. The problem that Public Works Department has found is that there are a number of trash cans missing. And I don't know how these large size trash cans could go missing, but we have found, at least in Old Webster, people literally take them somehow, even though they weigh a lot, people have been moving them away. And so when they move them, then they don't get picked up properly. But in addition, we have found that everything's being used so much with a lot of the walk, people doing takeout and the traffic and things like that. So what I just wanted to let you know is two things. One, the Public Works Department is going around and confirming like where trash cans are missing, where trash cans maybe need to be moved, where they might need to make sure that trash cans that are currently on private property need to go back to public property or on the sidewalk or near the sidewalk. So if there are any thoughts, I need anyone to share. So for example, if, and I'm just gonna pick on you, Holland, if Holland says, well, shoot, down here, we don't have, you know, there's a couple further down here, and she says, oh, there's one down here, but it's never used. I know yours is used, but it's never used. So please, you know, don't have one in front of my business. We could have that conversation and try to see where it best, they should all best be. Then once we get them in place, they're gonna put an overall map out back to the company for the pickups. Also know that the pickups usually are more frequent in the summer months of the year, knowing people are out and about, and then less frequent in the winter. But I know that we had a lot of early warm days, so there have been some issues or concerns with it being picked up. So we're going to go ahead and look at all of that, but I just wanted to give a quick heads up so that you can let me know if you think that there's a particular location where we need one, or if there's a particular location where you think something needs to be moved. And I, at this point in time, do not believe that this map is currently accurate. My understanding is both the trash cans in the Log Cabin Lane parking lot have disappeared and aren't there anymore. There's supposed to be two. So we kind of need to, they're gonna wander around, try to figure out where they all are, get a map together, figure out where they need to be, and we'll kind of go from there.
Well, I'll share my two cents first. I like the idea of having them in the parking lot. I park on the street a lot of times, back on Frisco Ave, sometimes in the far back of the lot if I'm in and out. I pick up trash every day. It's actually part of my handyman's. I pay someone to clean up that parking lot. So it'd be nice that if people have a place to put it. Out on front, I didn't know that there was two back there. I don't even ever remember there being two there since I've been around. So it's been a while. Out front, there's one that currently sits right by the light post, right between the Annex and Serendipity. The Annex and Serendipity are the two main culprits of trash on that side of the street. That's a perfect spot for it, where it currently is, in my opinion. You could put one down in front of the Frisco. I don't know that it needs to be that one needs to be down there personally. The next one is all the way down kind of between Webster Walk and Chiang Mai. And I think that that's a good spot for that one. There's probably a little bit of trash coming out of those places, but also more so probably people rounding the corner from Starbucks or from McDonald's, the kids. I say kids loosely, college kids also. And then really you go to the middle of the block and there's Edward Jones before there's, in my opinion, a need for another. And then I don't even know how much that one would get filled up. Right now there's only two on that side of the street that I see, right there between Serendipity and Annex. It gets overloaded since the Annex opened. It gets overloaded by Sunday, and every Monday morning it's flowing and there's trash falling out onto the street. I think one just down towards between Still Alchemy and Edward Jones maybe would help that cause, maybe help overflow fall into that area. That's just my opinion on that side of the street. The other side of the street, you have Einstein's and some Balkan, but mostly Einstein's. And so right there next to Union Studios, in front of there, I believe there's one that's 8135 and 8140 there. That one fills up and I see that one full a lot also. That one seems to make sense there. You probably could shift it closer to Einstein's maybe, to the 81, whatever that number is, 27, but it seems fine where it maybe closer to Einstein's would be okay. I think there might be one all the way down by Racanelli. It's almost down into Weber's then also, which is probably a good spot too. They have a little bit longer side of the block on that side of the street. And then I would think the other side would be to have one down closer to Balkan. And I don't believe there is one there right now. If Balkan was here, I bet you they would say that they don't really, their customer is taking most of the food to go and they don't need that there. It does get in the way. They're very busy on their sidewalks. Tons of people standing out on the sidewalk waiting to get food. If I were them, I wouldn't want a trash can sitting right out in front of my door. Maybe it rounds the corner onto Log Cabin or something. I don't know. Or no, that's North Old Orchard there. Instead of sitting right out in front of their place on Big Bend, but that's beyond me. I'm just giving an opinion on that one there.
The one that's in that parking lot behind Balkan and everything is always over full. Anytime walking back and forth, you just see it. It's constantly filled. So maybe if there's not one there at Balkan's corner, I can't remember. But I would agree if there's not, that something near Balkan or something that's catching when people eat and then they walk back to their car in that public lot. That one's the one that's over full. So
sorry to interrupt. I'm going to try to jump on in my car, but I got to take a kid to work.
So wrapping that whole one up, keeping one down near Weber's where it currently is probably good. And then right there between Union Studios and Einstein's, because the Einstein's is the major culprit in that section. And then getting into Balkan, maybe round the corner a little bit. There's a little bit of a hill there. I don't know how that would work, but maybe right around the corner, not on Big Bend, but right on North Old Orchard would be. Other than that, I didn't know there was any in the lots back behind there. Those probably don't hurt to be back there. As you're saying, it looks like it's full.
And Mara, is there anything or down by that gas station?
According to this map, there's one across the street, but not by the gas station.
Okay, maybe something nearer on that side that's just a thought or down. And what else opened up down further? Isn't there some walkable stuff?
Yeah, there's supposed to be one near the pharmacy. There's supposed to be one on the other side.
Okay. Well, and like you said, they're up. You're going to update exactly where they're at.
We're going to update exactly where they are. But yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And then once the new sidewalk goes in, there'll be a lot more ability to put them in there now that the sidewalk will be cleaned up.
How many did we do again? I'm sorry.
I think we had in the budget 2 to 3.
Okay. That's what I thought. Thank you.
So I'll give you an update next month. We're going to still we're going to go ahead and make the order, and then we're going to try to clean up where they all are and then make sure that once we figure out where they all are, that the maps go out correctly. Anything else on that?
It says I left the meeting. Am I still in here, guys?
You're still here. We got you.
All right. Okay. Sorry.
So I think we're done with trash can review. If anyone has any other trash can thoughts as they're wandering around in the next week or two, just let me know. Bob, we technically did the BDC update already, which was simply saying they're working on a number of different things. John is no longer, he stepped down from being also on BDC, just too much going on to be on both. So right now we don't have representation from Old Orchard on BDC, but we can continue to kind of talk that one through. And then if you're comfortable, I can go through a quick city update.
Sure.
Okay, so I'm gonna go through businesses first. You guys obviously know that Amy's Cake Pop Shop and Boozy Bites is open in your district. All the other things that were under construction are finishing up, are still under construction or finishing up, which includes Union Bagel, Le Macaron, Didi Mao, Wingstop, Zushi. The Total Access Urgent Care has started. They did their demolitions and they're getting their permits. I do have, Bob, I'm muting your second. You're on here twice.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, you're fine.
You're fine. we have where the next to Dewey's, where the dry cleaners used to be, is a new business going in called Eurotrash. They're an interior design firm. Down where the Gymboree used to be has been split into multiple tenant spaces. And we have a comic book store going in called Betty's Book. Rolling Ridge applied for a conditional use permit to use their space for events and classes and other things in either off hours when the nursery is not operating or in the evenings. And then during their down season that they can use it for other things like events and classes. They are at the city council for a final reading at the Tuesday meeting next week. A new business, Patterson Performing Arts, which does music lessons, applied for a conditional use permit in Webster Groves Presbyterian Church. They had their hearing before the Plan Commission last night. They're moving on to city council for their hearing on Tuesday. At city council last night, that went until 11:20 last night, we had both the CUP for Patterson Performing Arts. The Plan Commission voted to approve the text code amendment to allow multifamily, which would be allowed to have mixed use or multifamily only, with very specific regulations in both the C district and the D district. So if, for example, someone wanted to redevelop one of the properties within your district, and they want, we're going to follow everything that we have required in the code, which includes setbacks, height, intensity of use, required parking, landscaping, all of that. If they can meet all of that, it's an approved use, which means they don't have to rezone the property and they don't have to go through the steps for a conditional use permit, which allows them to do that within your district, but still follow all the regulations. They still have to go through architecture review board and have a site plan, but it would be a permitted use. That went through Plan Commission for 3 months and they approved it with a vote last night. It will move forward to city council, not at this next meeting on Tuesday, but in 3 weeks. And then there'll be another hearing at that point. If anyone has any questions about that, the Plan Commission had asked, you know, have you been letting the different business districts know that we're moving this forward? And I've been letting you know that we have the hearings. But if anyone has any questions about it, let me know. We have the development, SG Collaborative redevelopment rezoning for the Douglas Hill project, which is the area 15 acres north of Old Webster, opened up its public hearing last night before the Plan Commission. The only thing we did last night was kind of talk to them about the process of how rezonings work, where we're going to go and how we're going to operate moving forward. And then we allowed for all the public comment we'd received thus far, which was by the time everyone gets no more than like 3 minutes, some were less than 3 minutes, but the reading of public comments lasted for over 2 hours last night. And then we ended with the final reading of the comments and held the hearing open to our next meeting in July. At that point in July, we are moving the meeting to start at 6:30 because we went so long last night. We're going to have that hearing open and the applicants are going to make a presentation. So if anyone is curious about the proposal for the rezoning, please attend. We are still doing it kind of as a hybrid. Half of my Plan Commission members were at City Hall last night. Some of them were on Zoom. We did not have the public in. We did have over 65 people watching last night on the Zoom. We anticipate that it will grow as the meetings continue. There is, for those of you that are Webster residents, there is a Proposition 1 moving forward on the August election. The city council had approved a text amendment from the plan commission to allow for the ability to continue to have two family structures within one of our zoning districts. Our A4 zoning district has, since the 1950s and before, had in the code that you could have a two family structure on a single family lot in the A4 district. It was a permitted use, but it had some restrictions that essentially didn't allow it based on what other houses were on the block. That if you didn't have other two family, you couldn't build a new two family. So we opened up those restrictions, but still kept in all the regulations that you had to meet. The height, the parking, the intensity of use, it can't essentially be larger than a single family home that's there. And the city council moved it forward and approved it. A referendum came forward, and the number of signatures requires it to go to a public vote. So that public vote will be on the August election. There will be additional information provided by the council, well, not by the council, but by groups that I think are going to provide. I'm sure there's the group that did the referendum is going to provide information regarding that you should overturn the ordinance. And then there will be another group, I'm sure, that is asking for us to keep it in place. If anyone has any questions on that, especially anyone who lives in Webster, please let me know. And the budget from City Council had its public hearing at the last council meeting. It will be voted on to be approved at the next council meeting on Tuesday. And that will approve your budget for the new year. I think that's everything. I know Emerson's on. If he has anything else from the City Council, if anyone else has any other questions about anything going on, let me know. Business events. The street dance is a go at this point because of the restrictions being lifted. So is the jazz festival, as well as obviously your gazebo series. And then we are they canceled the Webster Arts Fair, but they've been doing some other small events. There's going to be some chalk artists coming and they're going to be doing some stuff in Old Webster, but I'll talk with them also about maybe expanding to do in Old Orchard. It's still a brand new thing that they're talking about. In addition, I have a permit in for community days to be on the Eden Seminary's property. So the carnival over there, the parade is still on and the parade is supposed to be because the 4th of July is on a Sunday this year. The parade will be on Saturday, July 3rd. So keep that in mind. I don't think I have anything else.
Mara, this is Ken. What's going on at Narex?
Oh, Narex is expanding their parking lot. So they are building and reconfiguring their entire parking lot in that whole front area of the building. They had to get approval for cleaning up their curb cut.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes. Let me know if you want to see any plans, but it's going to include lots of new landscaping, better configuration, and additional parking.
Okay.
All right. Do I just ask for a motion to adjourn?
If no one has anything else, you are good to go.
I'll make the motion to adjourn.
It's Angel. I'll second.
Everyone want to vote?
Aye.
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 Bye.
So next meeting's July 13th. Is anyone not going to be here? Any?
I will not be here on July 13th.
Okay. If it's just John, we still will have a quorum. If anything changes and people aren't going to be here, let us know. But other than that, enjoy your day.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah.